point, we're going to move to any motions or expedited papers. Mr. Clerk.
Mr. President, we have one paper for expedited consideration. That is Resolution Number 2013-R49 to amend Resolution Number 2013-R2-2, which designates which council members shall serve on the standing committees of council and the various boards, commissions, and committees to which council members are appointed for the purpose of appointing a council member to serve as a career and technical on the Career and Technical Education Commission. I will need a motion for expedited consideration of that paper. Dr. Newman, will you make that motion?
So moved, Madam Clerk.
Council is voting on Dr. Newman's motion for expedited consideration of Resolution Number 2013-R49. Mr. Belisle?
Aye.
Ms. Graziano?
Aye.
Ms. Mosby?
Aye.
Vice President Robertson?
Aye.
Mr. Adelasto?
Aye.
Mr. Gilbert?
Aye.
Ms. Trammell?
Aye.
Ms. Newcomb?
Aye.
President Samuels?
Aye.
That paper is before you for consideration.
Thank you very much. At this point, are there any questions from council about this paper? This paper simply amends committee assignments and other appointments. As you know, there were some authorities, boards, and commissions that were chaired or had members that are no longer with us after this recent election, and this resolves one of those issues by appointing Ms. Mosby to the Career and Technical Education Commission. At this point, we'll have a public hearing on the matter. Are those to speak in support? Are there those to speak in opposition? Please bring it back to the council, Mr. Clerk.
Council is voting on Resolution Number 2013.
I'm sorry. Point of members, is there any discussion by council members? I see none. Very well. Please let all the questions go.
Council is voting on Resolution Number 2013-R49. Mr. Belisle?
Aye.
Ms. Graziano?
Aye.
Ms. Mosby?
Aye.
Vice President Robertson?
Aye.
Mr. Adelasto?
Aye.
Mr. Gilbert?
Aye.
Ms. Trammell?
Aye.
Ms. Newbill?
Aye.
President Samuels?
Aye.
That paper has been adopted.
Thank you very much. Consent agenda?
The consent agenda consists of the following items. Item number one, ordinance number 2012-192, to amend and reordain Chapter 98, Article 8, Division 1 of the City Code by adding therein a new section 98-637.1 concerning a business license incentive program for qualifying businesses for the purpose of exempting new businesses that locate within the city from paying business, professional, and occupational license taxes for a period not to exceed 2 years. Item number three, ordinance number 2013-1, to authorize the CAO for and on behalf of the City of Richmond to execute a lease as amended between Powell Ventures as lessor and the City of Richmond as lessee for the purpose of providing a temporary site for the East End Library at 3019 Hill Road, Unit C and Unit B for a period of 6 months beginning February 1, 2013. Item number four, ordinance number 2013-2, to amend and reordain City Code Section 110-37 concerning taxi cab rates for the purpose of providing that for a trip originating at Richmond International Airport, the rate shall be $10 for the charge registered on the meter, whichever is greater, plus $2. Item number five, ordinance number 2013-3, to authorize the CAO to accept $50,000 from the Virginia Department of Emergency Management and to appropriate the increase to the fiscal year 12-13 special fund budget by increasing estimated revenues and the amount appropriated to the Department of Fire and Emergency Services by $50,000 for the purpose of a Richmond MSA public outreach and education project. Item number seven, ordinance number 2013-5, to authorize the special use of the property known as 3600 Forestville Avenue for the purposes of permitting live entertainment and an outdoor dining area on certain terms and conditions. Item number eight, ordinance number 2013-8, to amend ordinance number 2009-102-114, adopted June 22nd, 2009, which authorized the special use of the property known as 508 Liberty Avenue for office use with accessory parking, to authorize office use in the existing basement upon certain terms and conditions. Item number nine, ordinance number 2013-9, to close public decent travel portion of West 24th Street located north of Perry Street between West 22nd and West 24th Streets, consisting of approximately 2,584 square feet upon certain terms and conditions. Item number 10, ordinance number 2013-11, to authorize the special use of the property known as 4030 MacArthur Avenue for the purposes of permitting an outdoor dining area and expansion of the existing building upon certain terms and conditions. Item number 12, ordinance number 2013-18, to authorize the CAO to accept funds in the amount of $135,185 from the U.S. Department of Homeland Security and to appropriate the increase to the fiscal year 2013 special fund budget by increasing estimated revenues in the amount appropriated to the Department of Fire and Emergency Services by $135,185 for the purpose of providing for the purchase of computer hardware and software to increase critical information sharing and collaboration efforts between the city and other entities that support Richmond and generally within the city of Richmond. Item number 13, ordinance number 2013-19, to amend ordinance number 2012-188-2013-3, adopted January 28th, 2013, which ordained the new city code, section 98-249.1, imposing a moratorium on acceptance of applications from nonprofit organizations for exemption from real or tangible personal property taxation for the purpose of temporarily extending the deadline for the completion of the property tax exemption by designation committees to review of applications for tax exemption by designation and the deadline for which ordinances exempting property from taxation must be introduced beyond the deadline set forth in city code, section 98-248.
Thank you, Madam Clerk. Are there persons that wish to speak in favor of any item on the consent agenda?
Mr. President, Madam Vice President, members of council, good evening. My name is Troy Bellum. I'm Director of Marketing and Air Service Development at Richmond International Airport. I'd like to briefly speak in support of item number four on the consent agenda, ordinance 2013-2. This is to amend and reordain city code concerning taxi rates for trips originating at Richmond International Airport. For the very reason that the airport believes that this amendment supports improved safety and appearance for taxi cab services at Richmond International Airport. This is supported by the airport itself, by ground transportation operators, and we are saying this supports on behalf of visitors to the Richmond region. We appreciate your consideration and adoption of this measure. That's it.
Thank you very much, Mr. Bell. Please, thank you. Seeing no one else coming to the podium, is someone else going to speak in favor?
Mr. President, Madam Vice President, members of council, Andy Conlin. Just here to speak about item number 10 regarding the special use on 4030 MacArthur Avenue, that's back in with the outdoor dining. We have a number of folks here that are waiting to get out of here, get back, celebrate at the new location on very MacArthur Avenue that you just gave a nice award to for coming and doing all the great things that you do. So we'll be happy to answer any questions if you want. If anyone in opposition would like to reserve some time to answer those questions, that's all we have.
Any others to speak in favor?
Hello, my name is Will Herring. I'm one of the owner-operators of Crossroads Coffee at 3600 Forestville. Sorry, I don't remember the number of our special use permit. Forgive me, but my partner, Lydia Patrick, is here with me. And I also have, last week, accumulated over 500 signatures from customers who would like to see us keep our outside seating in place and a lot of users to come up. Critical part of our business model. I just want to thank you for your time and ask for your support. Also, I'd just like to say what a thrill it's been to operate Crossroads for 10 years in the neighborhood where we live. I don't know a lot of work, I'm just a few blocks away. It's a neighborhood place, and we draw from some neighborhoods in the area. And it's a real pleasure to be doing this for 10 years. So thank you for your time, for your consideration. I don't know if there's a protocol for submitting petitions or not.
You can be with the clerk, you can place a number, she'll come around and grab it.
Okay, thank you so much, appreciate your time.
Thank you. If there's anybody else in support of me, please line up behind this show.
Mr. President, Madam Vice President, I'm Paul Franco, I'm a citizen of the city of Richmond. Council members, and I'm here today to support the ordinance, I think it's 2013-5 for Crossroads. I'm a citizen of Woodland Heights, live in the neighborhood, and I'm hoping to come out here to support my friend Lauren Olivia. They have made a wonderful place for Crossroads. I've lived in Woodland Heights all the years that I've lived in Richmond, and I can tell you truthfully that it's a better neighborhood because of Crossroads. It's a central meeting point for residents. The live music is added just a new dimension, and it's a wonderful place for the citizens to come and hang out and relax, and I urge you to adopt special use permit. Thank you.
Thank you. Anybody here to speak in opposition to anything? If there's anybody here to speak in opposition, please come down and line up.
My name is Betty Clark. I live at 401 Bland Street, up the street from the coffee shop. And the reason I'm not for it because I don't have anywhere to park. But they have something that's parked on both sides of the streets. And my daughter, we have a special parking for her because she's handicapped. And most of the time, I have to walk to the coffee shop and tell them to move the cars and get an attitude. I'm not for it. Because one reason I'm not for it is another one because I was on my porch one day, the firemen came in on Foster Avenue. They couldn't come in on Foster Avenue. They had to back all the way out to Foster Avenue to get to Bland Street and go up the hill. And I live at 401, if that was my house, what would I do? What could I do if the firemen came to my house on both sides of the street? Both sides of the streets, it's called on both sides of the street, so I had to wait on this end for this person to come by. So this person had to wait for the other one to come back. That's all women have something at the shop on both sides of the street. It's no pockets. People can't get by. Thank you.
My name is Elvis Burke. I'm not opposed to what Bill wants to do. I just think that if he wants to do it, he has to start the parking space. You know, he has to work out the parking issues with his customers.
Thank you very much. Seeing no others in support or opposition to any papers, we bring it back to council for discussion. Is there any council discussion on any paper on tonight's consent agenda? I see Mr. Angelos in his hand.
Thank you. With regards to Crossroads Coffee House, I appreciate everybody coming down tonight to speak in favor and in opposition to this. It's clearly a business that has operated for 10 years, and that's a tremendous feat given the climate of the last few. And I congratulate you for being an added amenity for the community, and I know that they greatly appreciate your service. When it comes to parking and traffic concerns, I know that there's been some voices heard on this issue, and I know that we've been trying to push some things over to the administration and ask Tom Flynn to work with us so that we can satisfy both the issues regarding parking, the dangerous intersection at Forest Hill and Sims. So I'm committed to making sure that those issues get resolved, but I personally don't think that the traffic concerns and or some of the parking concerns that may or may not be addressed by Crossroads would be something to hold up this special use permit. In the end, they have been operating this business for 10 years with no code violations. And at this stage, they're simply asking to be put into compliance.
Thank you, Mr. Angelos. Are there any other comments about any of the papers on the consent?
Mr. President.
Mr. Hill.
Thank you, Mr. President. I just want to say
And I'll speak briefly as to one paper, and that's the first paper on tonight's agenda, which exempts new businesses and relocating businesses from the business professional license tax. To businesses, or to folks that are thinking about starting a business in the city or looking to relocate a business from a county, please know the city with this paper is saying, we want to work with you and work with the business. For businesses that are in the city and have been loyal to the city, please know that during tonight's introduction of papers, we will be introducing a paper that will appoint a task force to review the current business and professional license tax and provide a report back with recommendations on what we can do as a council and as a city to bring it into a situation that is substantially better for business while not negatively affecting the city's bottom line. I look forward to working with the members of that task force for the gains of the change. But please know that we are paying attention to both current businesses and encouraging new businesses to locate our city. Thank you. Call questions to clerk.
Council is voting on tonight's consent agenda items as presented, which include item 1, items 3 through 5, 7 through 10, 12, and 13. Mr. Velazquez?
Aye.
Ms. Graziano?
Aye.
Ms. Mosby?
Aye.
Vice President Robertson?
Aye.
Mr. Adjuesto?
Aye.
Mr. Hilbert?
Aye.
Ms. Trammell?
Aye.
Ms. Newbill?
Aye.
President Samuels?
Aye.
Consent agenda has been adopted.
Thank you very much. At this point, we'll have approval of the minutes.